Welcome to the mini-guide for Conquest of the Aegean. Conquest of the Aegean is a game about the German attempt to conquer the Mediterranean during World War II. You can play a game over the internet, either by hosting or joining a game, but for now let's just start a new game. As you can see, there are about 36 different scenarios here, ranging from 1.5 to 9 days. Let's just start with a small one, Platamon. Tanks at Platamon. You can play the game from either the Axis side or from the Allies. For now we're gonna play as the Axis and let's just start a scenario. You can use the minimap to move around the screen. Zoom in, zoom out again, or by using the mouse wheel. Going to the edge of the screen moves your battlefield map. Okay, let's have a look at our units. If you select a unit of your own, you'll get a lot of statistics here about that unit: personnel, equipment, morale, cohesion. What's very important is the anti-personnel and the anti-armor value. These indicate the combat strengths of your unit. Also very important, fatigue. If this gets too high, your unit will fail to respond to orders. When you select an enemy unit, you get some statistics too, but they are not very reliable because there's fog of war in that game. Now, as you see, these units are dug in on the ridge here. The reason they're dug in is because there are victory locations here and here. You'll see the points you'll get for those victory locations here. Okay. Another thing you need to know is that Conquest of the Aegean is not played in turns. It's not a turn-based game, it's a continuous time game, which means that the action unfolds continuously but is possible at any given moment so you can give orders. Okay, so what's the plan? I'm not going to frontally assault the ridge here, but I'm going to try to take the victory location here, but I'll need a diversionary attack. That's why I'm selecting a company and giving it a probe order. You can place waypoints by holding down the shift key. Finally there, that's fine. Then I'm selecting the battalion headquarters, and here's a thing that's very important: you don't need to give orders to each and every one of your units. If you just give an order to the battalion will take care of its companies and will give orders to its own companies. So attack, waypoints, final destination, and set some parameters. The frontage can be a little bit smaller, the depth as well. I'm going to make a successive lines assault: speed fastest, route quickest, aggressiveness maximum, rate of fire rapid. Okay. This final waypoint looks a bit funny because it's the forming up point. At this point the units will shake out into a formation and assault the final destination. Let's get this game running. I'm going to pause here for a second to show you that each and every one of those companies has been given a march route by the battalion headquarters to which we have given the attack order. Okay, continue. As these units are crossing the bridge, you're getting fired upon by the enemy units on the ridge here. Nothing dramatic, so let's just continue. The units here, the lead unit here, is getting heavy fire upon it and also taking casualties, but there's nothing we can do right now, so let's continue. You can see that the mortar platoon here has dropped off to provide fire support for the attack. And the probing attack, well, it served its purpose, so we're just going to cancel that attack and give it a defend order. Somewhere safe, somewhere here. Okay. Continue. The assault seems to be going well. Okay. Now you can see that the victory location here has changed color. That's because we've attained, at this point in time, the victory location. There's still an enemy unit there, but we outnumber it 10-1, so it's gone. So with the victory location firmly in our hands, we've come to the end of this 5-minute guide to conquest of the Aegean. I hope you enjoyed it.